Welcome to third lecture of module 3, and this lecture will be on equipment for gas liquid operations. We are discussing the equipments for gas disperse, and we are designing the plate column, and we have seen in our previous lecture how to determine or how to design the tower diameter for a plate column. In this lecture, we will continue design of the plate column like pressure drop. We will discuss the entrainment, weeping and tray efficiency. So, which are the important parameters to design for a plate column? So, pressure drop for a ship tray, we can write H T is equal to H D plus H L plus H S, where H T is the total pressure drop per plate, which is centimeter of liquid. And HD is the dry plate pressure drop centimeter of liquid. HL is the hydraulic head centimeter of liquid, and HS is the heat loss due to the surface tension. And this is also centimeter of liquid. Now, how to calculate this dry plate pressure drop and HL and HS so that we can obtain the total pressure drop? We will go one by one. Let us consider the dry plate pressure drop. And this we can obtain by a modified orifice type equation, which is proposed by Ludwig. H D is equal to 0.0051 V H by C O square rho G rho W rho L into 1 minus A H by A A square. So, where V H is the gas velocity through the hole, meter per second, rho W is the density of water, and rho L is the density of liquid, C O is the orifice coefficient, and C O can be obtained. CO is equal to 0.85032 minus 0.04231 DH by LT plus 00171954 dH by LT square. For dH is the diameter of the hole and LT is the thickness of the plate, should be this ratio should be greater than 1.0. So, LT is the thickness of the plate and diameter of the hole. So, from this we can calculate HD. Now, let us calculate the hydraulic head HL. Hydraulic head this depends on wear height and also it depends on liquid and gas densities rho L and rho G, and also it depends on downcomer length. So, the equations which can be used, H L will be equal to beta H W R plus C W R Q L by L W R beta to the power 2/3, where H W R is the wear height, L W R is the downcomer length. Now, let us consider beta. Beta is the effective relative for the density, effective relative for the density, and can be calculated with is equal to exponential minus 12.55 C S to the power 0.91, where C S is the capacity parameter and is equal to, we can write V A rho g by rho l minus rho g to the power 1/2. V A, this V A we can, this is the superficial gas velocity and it is in unit of meter per second, and V A which is superficial gas velocity based on tray active area, and QL is the liquid flow rate across plate, which is in meter cube per second. CWR we can calculate using the following equation: 12 plus 43.89 exponential minus 1.378 HWR. So, this way we can calculate the hydraulic pressure drop, hydraulic head, and then we can calculate the surface tension pressure drop. Surface tension pressure drop. This can be done by equating the force inside the bubble and outside the bubble. Outside the bubble is the surface tension force, and if we do the force balance, between the internal force of a bubble and the surface tension force. So, we can write H s is equal to 6 sigma L divided by G rho L d H. D H is the whole diameter and sigma L is the surface tension force of the liquid, and this whole area or the bubble size can be taken as the maximum bubble size can be taken as the whole diameter. So, we can obtain this surface tension force. Now, the entrainment of the liquid can occur at high vapor or gas rate. So, if the vapor or gas rate is high, entrainment is higher, and hence decrease the efficiency of the plate or efficiency of the tower, decrease the efficiency. So, this can be defined the fractional entrainment can be defined as the ratio of the mass transfer rate of entrant liquid or mass flow rate of entrant liquid divided by the mass flow rate of the upward gas. Mass flow rate of the upward gas. So, this is the fractional entrainment, and this can be calculated using the following correlation. E t will be equal to 0.0335 h beta by T s to the power 1.1 rho L by rho g to the power 0.5 H L by H beta to the power k. T s is the trace spacing, and H beta is the height of two phase region on the plate. So, this H beta we can calculate is H L by beta plus 7.79 into 1 plus 6.9 d h by h l to the power 1.85 into C s square divided by beta g A h by A a, and this k is a constant, we can calculate it is 0.5 into 1 minus 10 hyperbolic 1.3 ln h l by d h minus 0.15. So, using this equation we can obtain the entrainment, fractional entrainment, and the fractional entrainment should not exceed 10%. And much below this 10% is desired. So, whipping is another factor for the plate column. So, whipping depends on the following factors. One is fractional hole area, and then it liquid rate, wear height, surface tension of the liquid, plate thickness, and pitch length. As we can see, if the fractional hole area is more and whipping will be more, liquid rate is higher means whipping will be also higher, and higher wear height will lead to whipping, higher whipping, and surface tension of the liquid should be, if it is lower then the whipping will be more, plate thickness if it is lesser then whipping also increases, and if pitch length is smaller so whipping will be more. So, it is proposed that if the Froude number which is equal to rho g by rho l v h by g h l to the power 0.5 is greater than equal to 0.5, then whipping is not a major problem in this case. So, before designing if we calculate the Froude number which is coming greater than 0.5, so we can consider the whipping is not a severe problem. So, now we will discuss the tray efficiency. So, let us consider this is n plus 1th tray, this is nth tray, and this is n minus 1th tray. So, the tray efficiency is the fractional approach. By a real tray, to an equilibrium stage. The contact among the gas and liquid in the plate is not uniform, and the efficiency varies from point to point. So, first we will discuss the point efficiency. point efficiency. So, this is end plate and the vapor which is coming out is y n local, and the liquid which is coming out from this is x n local, and the vapor coming from n minus 1th tray is y n plus 1 local. So, we can write point efficiency E O G is y n local minus y n plus 1 local divided by y n local star minus y n plus 1 local. That is actual enrichment of the gas divided by maximum enrichment. So, y n plus 1 local is the local concentration of the gas leaving n plus 1th tray, and y n local is the local concentration of the gas leaving nth tray, and y n star local is the concentration in equilibrium with x n local. So, now the following assumptions were taken. For point efficiency, one is the local concentration x n local is constant in the vertical direction. That means, in the vertically the liquid is well mixed. So, the concentration at each point is same, which is x n local, and the second one, the gas flows at plug flow, that is there is change in concentration along the depth of the liquid. So, this tray efficiency depends on the mass transfer coefficient and the interfacial area. Now, we will try how to correlate between, we will try to correlate between the point efficiency with mass transfer coefficient and the interfacial area. Let us consider this is one plate whose liquid depth is here L is equal to 0 and here L is equal to L, and this is the point small thickness of the liquid on the plate we are considering, which is dl, and the small area we can consider, which is ds, and then in this side say the concentration change here is y, and at this point y plus dy, and let gs is a molar gas flow rate and assumed constant, and this is at the top surface, this is y n local. So, d l is the small thickness, d s is the small area. So, if we do the steady state mass balance, over the small thickness dl, the rate of mass transfer to the gas is equal to gs dy ds. So, the change in concentration is dy. So, this is the mass transfer rate, and assume change in concentration of gas is dy in dl thickness. So, here we have assumed the mass transfer occur from the gas phase to the liquid phase, from gas to liquid. So, the mass transfer rate again we can write is equal to K y a, capital K y a d s d l y n star local minus y. K y overall mass transfer coefficient, A is the specific area, d s d l small volume, and A d s d l is the gas liquid contact area, in the small volume of dispersion, and y n local star minus y, this is the local mass transfer driving force, at any height L from the tray floor. Now, if we equate these two mass transfer rate, it will give you G s d s d y would be equal to K y A d s d l y n local star minus y. So, if we integrate over the height L, this will be integral y n plus 1 local to y n local d y by y n local star minus y is equal to integral 0 to L k y a d L by g s. So, this will be minus L n y n star local minus y n local divided by y n local minus y n plus 1 local is equal to k y a l by g s, which is known as n t o g. This is the number of overall gas transfer unit, number of overall gas transfer unit. We can write minus ln 1 minus this part this one would be equal to minus ln 1 minus E O G. So, it is equal to N T O G. So, we can write E O G is equal to 1 minus e to the power minus N T O G. So, this is the equations we can derive. If N T O G is very high, N T O G is very high, then E O G will be equal to 1. So, this means the stage will approach to the equilibrium stage. So, for this we need to know the value of k y a, the point efficiency. To calculate the point efficiency we need k y a. So, if we do not have, then we can use the following correlations proposed for. So, these correlations we can use E O G will be equal to 1 minus exponential minus 0.0029 divided by 1 plus M C G by C L root over D G by D L 1 minus beta divided by A H by A A R E F to the power 0.14136 H L by D H to the power 0.676074 into A H by A A to the power minus 0.3195. where REF is equal to rho g VH HL by mu g beta. M is the slope of the equilibrium curve and C g and C L, these are the molar concentration of the gas and liquid respectively, and d g and d l are the diffusion coefficient of gas and liquid. So, this way we can calculate the point efficiency. Now, we will consider the another type of efficiency which is known as Murphy efficiency. To derive the Murphy efficiency, it is assumed that the gas leaving the dispersion at different location of a tray get mixed before entering to the upper tray. And the concentration of the liquid changes on the upper tray, changes on the tray. So, this is defined EMG is equal to Y n minus y n plus 1 divided by y n star minus y n plus 1. And this y n and y n plus 1, these are the average concentration, average concentration of gas in the nth and n plus 1th tray. Now, two cases may arise in this case. Case 1, when the liquid on the tray is completely bag mixed, liquid on the tray is completely bag mixed, then this EMG will be EOG. And if the liquid flows on the tray is plug flow, liquid flow on the tray is plug flow, then we can write that is no axial mixing, in that case we can write EMG will be A into exponential EOG by A minus 1. So, A is the L by mg and m is the Henry's law constant. Now, the overall efficiency EO is defined as the number of ideal stage divided by number of real stage, and the following relations between EMG and overall efficiency can be derived ln 1 plus E m g 1 by A minus 1 divided by ln 1 by A. Only when the gas and liquid rate G and L and the slope of the equilibrium curve are constant. And the second is E m g is same for all three. So, in this situation we can derive between these two. Now, let us consider a simple example. Ammonia is absorbed by pure water from air ammonia mixer using a sieve tray tower. The mixer contains 10% ammonia, 90% air. It is desired to remove 90% ammonia. The gas entered at the bottom of the tower at the flow, that is the flow is counter current, and the flow rate of gas and liquid are same, at is 150 kilomole per hour. The surface tension of liquid is given 72 dyne per centimeter at 298 Kelvin. The diameter of the sieve is 2 millimeter, which is on an equilateral triangular piece of 10 millimeter. Assume 40 millimeter wear height and molecular weight of ammonia is 17 and air is 29. The density of the liquid is given is 1000 kg per meter cube and the recommended foaming factor is 0.75. Design the tower for an 75% approach to the flooding velocity. Now, let us consider how to calculate the diameter. We can calculate the average mass m of the gas mg average, which is equal to 0.1 into 17 plus 0.9 into 29. So, it will be 27.8, and the gas flow rate which is given is 150 into 27.8 divided by 3600. So, it will be 1.158 kg per second. Now, rho g we can calculate P t m g average by R t. So, putting this value it will be 1.137 kg per second. Now, ammonia absorbed is equal to 150 into 0.1 into 0.9 into 17 is equal to 229.5 kg per hour. Now, L dash is 150 into 18 plus 229.5 divided by 3600. So, it will be 0.814 kg per second, and rho L is given 1000 kg per meter cube. So, m we can calculate L dash by g dash into rho g by rho L to the power half, which is equal to point. So, if we substitute this value, this will be 0.024. So, slope is known. Now, we can calculate A h by A A is 0.90907 d h by P h square, 0.9072 by 10. The pitch length is 10 and the sieve dia is 2 square. So, it will be 0.037. Now, we can assume tray spacing is 0.6 meter, then we can calculate alpha, which is 0.0744 T s plus 0.01173. So, this will be around, substituting this T s will be 0.0564, and beta we can calculate 0.0304 T s plus 0.015, which is equal to 0.0332. Since m is less than 0.1, we have calculated, we can use m is equal to 0.1. So, C f we can calculate alpha log 1 by m plus beta. So, substituting these values, this will be 0.0896. Now, we know that A h by A t is less than 0.1. So, F h a we can calculate 5 into A h by A a plus 0.5, and this will give 0.618. F s t also we can calculate, which is sigma L by 20 to the power 0.2, and which is equal to 72 dyne by 20 to the power 0.2, which will be equal to 1.292. So, and we can calculate, we have taken the factor 0.8. So, now we can calculate C s b is equal to F s t, F f, F h a and C f. Substituting these values, this will be equal to 0.0572 meter per second. Now, we can calculate gas flow rate, volumetric flow rate, which is g dash by rho g, and which is equal to 1.158 divided by 1.137, which is equal to 1.019 meter cube per second. Now, V F L is C S B rho g minus rho L minus rho g by rho g to the power half. Now, substituting these values, it will be 1.696 meter per second. So, since m is less than 0.1 meter, we can use a d by a t is equal to 0.1, and 75% approach to flooding . So, we can obtain d t is equal to 4 q g by f v l f l 1 minus a d by a t into pi to the power half. So, substituting this, this will be 1.064 meter. So, since the diameter is greater than 1 meter and below 3 meter, so we can write the assumptions of T s is equal to 0.6 is correct. So, no more iteration is required to calculate the diameter with the assumed stray spacing. Now, we can calculate A d by A t is known to us 0.1, and A d by A t we know that theta minus sin theta by 2 is pi. So, from this we can calculate theta is equal to 1.627 radian. And d is known, so LWR, which is length, we can calculate, which will be 0.773, and LRWR will be around 0.366 meter. So, the trace pressure drop the wear height is given, HWR is 40 millimeter, and then we can calculate tower cross sectional area, AT is pi into d square by 4, which is equal to 0.889 meter square, and since AD by AT is equal to 0.1, we can downcomer area AD, we can calculate 0.1 into AT, which is 0.089 meter square. Then active area AA can be calculated, AT minus 2 is AD, so we can, this will be around 0.711 meter square. Now AH by A is 0.037, so H will be 0.026 meter square. VH QG by AH, if we substitute, it is 39.19 meter per second. So DH by LT is 2 by 2 is 1.0, and rho W is 1000 kg per meter cube. So, with this we can calculate CO, which is 0.85032 minus 0.04231 dH by LT plus 0.0017954 dH by LT to the power square. So, if we substitute, this will be 0.81. Now, HD we can calculate, which is 0.0051 VH by CO square rho G rho W by rho L 1 minus AH by AA square. So, this will be about 13.54 centimeter. Now, we can calculate VA QG by AA, which is 1.433 meter per second, and CS we can obtain is substituting the data, 0.048 meter per second. Beta we can obtain then exponential minus 12.55 CS to the power 0.91. So, this will be 0.451. Now, QL L dash by rho L, which is 8.14 into 10 to the power minus 4 meter cube per second, and we can HWR is 40 millimeter, which is 4 centimeter. So, we can calculate CWR, which is equal to 50.297. So, from this we can calculate HL, which is 2.2 centimeter. Similarly, if we know the sigma L, which is 72 dynes per centimeter is equal to 0.072 newton per meter. So, H s we can calculate 6 into 0.072 divided by 9.81 into 1000 into 2 into 10 to the power minus 3. So, which is 0.022 meter, which is 2.2 centimeter. So, the total head H t is equal to 13.54 plus 2.2 plus 2.2. So, total is 17.94 centimeter. So, the other part of the design like entrainment calculations, if we substitute this data, we can see that there is not much entrainment for the liquid and the weeping also less, the Froude number will be around 0.5. So, in the next class, we will discuss the equipment for liquid disperse. Thank you for your attention.